If you are using Highlevel or thinking about opening a Highlevel account, then one of the things you're going to have to do is connect your Stripe account to your Highlevel account. Now, this video is specifically for those people who have not created a Stripe account yet. This is what we're going to be talking about and get through in this particular video here. Before we get started, my name is rayodaniel. Thank you so much for visiting my channel. Please click on the subscribe button if you have not already to help support the channel. Thank you again, and let's get to it. Awesome. So right now we're at the main Stripe page. This is just what Stripe looks like at the time of this video. I'm also logged into my Gmail account just to make that easier, because you will need to have an email address associated with an admin account on your Stripe. So once we do that, we're going to go ahead and get started by clicking on the Start Now button here. Now what we're going to do here initially is just simply start by entering the basic information here. And I've got a sort of demo account created here. Give me a second. Just to demonstrate this purpose here. This, you can put in your name or the company name, however you wanna have it show up. I'm just gonna put in Digi Global Agency, and then you're gonna create your password here. So let's go ahead and get the password created. Now, this does need to be a strong password, so that typically means 8 characters or more, uppercase, lowercase, numbers, special characters, things like that entered. But you see, the very first thing it's going to have us do before we move it forward with anything, it's going to say, please verify your email address. So we're going to hop back over here and see if we can get our email address created here. And there we go. It just took it a second, but we've got our email address. We're going to click on our verify email button. Now, once we do this, this right here will take us to the rest of the sort of automated process with Stripe. Notice that this other page is created. I am logged into the Stripe account. Your account has been created, but there are several other things that you need to do first before you can continue and use this in Highlevel. You do need to create account. You need to put in your bank account information. You need to what they call activate your account or activate your payments in here, because without activating your payments, Highlevel will not enable any of your order forms yet, because you won't be able to utilize the payment gateway because you don't have your account set up for payments yet. So we're going to go through and just say complete your profile. This is going to be a multi-step process. So let's walk through it here. So first of all, we need to find out what type of person are you? Are you an individual, or you actually are a company? Individual means you're just going to be using your social security number. If you're a company, then that means you formed an LLC, and you've got most of the time, if you're going to be dealing with Highlevel, you will have a company account. So I'm just going to choose company. For this, you can do sole proprietor, single member, multi-member. We won't get into that. Right now, this is just going to be set up as a single member. Just means that one person owns the LLC and is completely responsible for any decision making. So here we're going to click continue. Next, it's just going to ask for some of the business details here. So once we get through here, what is the legal business name? I'm just going to put in Digi Global Agency. So that's the name of the agency we got up here. Give me a second. Let me get the this EIN number we created entered here, so we can paste that. Now, doing business as, this just means if you have sort of a fictitious name registration, or your main company is called one thing, but maybe you've registered a fictitious name, which is another way of saying DBA or doing business as, you can enter it here. I do not. So right now we're going to move forward with just the address. We're going to type in the address of your particular business. Once we have this business website, it wants all the information here. So we're going to go ahead and put in the website information. Now, product description here, this be sure to enter the product description. Otherwise, you will get an error here. So right now, I'm just going to put in digital courses right here. You can put in whatever else you say, marketing agency, or just say, yeah, digital courses and marketing agency. So that right there should be good enough for your product description. We're going to go ahead and click next. Right now, I'm so sorry here. I'm going to see if I can pop back to business details. Right now, you do need to select an industry. I kind of skipped over that. So right now, if you go down, you will see like digital products. You might be one of these other ones, depending upon what your business is set up as. But I'm just going to do digital products for the service for this example, and just do other digital goods. So I just wanted to do that before we continued. Otherwise, you would end up getting an error at the end of your account saying your information is not correct. So the business representative, Stripe wants to know who's the main contact person here. So this is where you would enter your information, your email address. You would put in your date of birth here. Okay, so this is where we put in the address, and this could be different than the business address if that's what it is, or you can enter the same address if you want to. Phone number here. Now, this is going to be important here. Depending upon with Stripe, you will have to implement two-factor authentication. So in order to get to use the SMS version of, you know, where you log in, text you a code, you'd have to enter the code in, and most people are familiar with that. Please make sure you enter a number regarding a cell phone. I have seen it where some virtual numbers, some like Google Voice or Voice over IP or some numbers like that may not receive the text messages regarding this. Just it happens sometimes depending upon the carrier. But I'm going to go ahead and enter our cell phone here. And right now it is asking for the last four digits of the tax ID number, which I will put in here and then click continue. So right now, just making sure that all the information is correct. Now that is going to ask us for our fulfillment. Right now, because I am this example is a digital course provider, marketing agency, I'm going to say this is within 1 day. Right now, you know, if you have to make something that's going to take a couple weeks, or if this is build to order kind of thing, you might select something different, but I'm just going to say within 1 day. To click continue here. Now, the public details are what's going to be important here. So this right here is where on your credit card statement here, this is what people will see on the credit card statement whenever they make a charge to you. If you've ever looked at that, typically it has like who it's coming from, maybe a little description, and then a phone number associated with that so you could potentially call. So right now, I would say fill in all of these. Now you do have a limit of your shortened descriptor, but that's what we'll put in here. I'm just going to use the same cell phone in this one. If you have a different support line or different phone number to call, you would enter that here. So all the other information is good to go. We're going to click continue. Now it's going to say add your bank account information here. There's a couple of different ways you can do this. I like to make sure that we could do it quickly here. So right now, rather than searching for your bank, and then it'll pull up a screen where you have to put in your online login and password and connect to your bank account and do all that other good stuff, I would just come down here where it says enter bank account information directly. Here I'm going to go ahead and put in just if you have your route. This is where you would need your routing number as well as your checking account number. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in. So it's nice if you could just simply copy and paste it. Once you put this in and click save, then this right here will get your bank account set up, and you will see your bank account being added on here. Perfect. So this is an important step in the online processing part of it here, because this is where if you don't have this set up, then there's no way for Stripe to make the send the payments to you to get into your bank account. So we're going to go ahead and click continue. It's going to ask us which way do we want to use this. We can use an authenticator app, security key, just to make it easy. I'm just going to use SMS. It will pop up and ask us to confirm. Give me a second. I've got my cell phone here. Let me get this code. Got it. Got a low security here. So once we do this, I've saved my backup code. This is all done. So we see a check next to SMS that has been verified and good to go. Now, right now, we're not going to go through tax calculations, but this, if you do have to collect tax and so forth, work with your CPA to get this set up here. But this is way beyond the scope of just creating a Stripe account that I want to get into on this one. So I'm just going to say no, thank you. Now, any kind of contributions here, I'm just going to say no thanks and move on to get this account finished. Notice review and setup here. Everything is good to go. We can click agree and submit. and then everything should be good. At this particular point, your Stripe account should be set up, your payment verifications should be set up, and everything should be good to go. Now that we've done this, this is kind of the hard part. So now is going to be the easy part as far as going back in, and give me a second here, hopping back into Highlevel here. Now that you've got your Highlevel account set up here, this is a sub account that we have. I just want to show you how you would actually make the connection with Stripe so that the account inside of Highlevel can now start accepting payments. So here, the easiest way is just to come down to the payments tab, our payments menu option, and then go to integrations. Here you see Stripe. It just simply says connect with Stripe. Pretty straightforward. Right now, our email address is still in here, so we will just go ahead and, if it's not, then just put in the email address of the account that you just created, your Stripe account, or whatever you use to create it. It just has to be an admin level account on here. So let's go ahead and click. We're going to go ahead and put in the password for this. Log in. Of course, we need to go through the verification again. Give me just a second. I just got it. That's correct. We're going to connect the Digi Global Agency account to our account here. So right now, we've done that. Beautiful. Now we see Stripe Live Mode is enabled, Stripe Test Mode is enabled. So this is very important because we want to make sure that both are enabled here because of this reason here. Obviously, Live is so we can accept payments, but the test account is good because right now, if you build a funnel, you want to be able to sit back and test it here. So let me see if I have a funnel on this one here. We'll just use this newsletter funnel here I've been playing with real quick as a test. But right now, if you wanted to, inside of here, you can click on the settings of this. And actually, for the payment mode, notice that this is set to live. You can actually click on test mode for your funnel. And what this allows you to do is go through the process of your entire funnel, use the fake 424242 whatever credit card account that Stripe gives you for that, and actually look like you're making payments. That way, everything goes through. You could check your workflows. You could check everything else. But all of that goes back to making sure that your that this test mode is enabled. If it is enabled, great. Then you can work. You can test all of your funnel purchases and everything else, and make sure that your follow-up sequence, your order completion pages work. You can make sure your email campaigns work. Your texting works. All of that stuff works with your Stripe account. So hopefully you found this video useful with getting it connected, your Highlevel account connected with Stripe. If you did find this video useful, smash a like button. Maybe leave me a comment if you thought it was a good video here and it helped you out. I certainly do appreciate it, and you guys have a great day. And again, if you have not, hit the subscribe button here. Help a brother out. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.